With approvals, you can manage your workflow within a defined process and formalize authority levels as you prepare planning data. You can review and approve plans submitted by cost centers or departments as a part of your overall budgeting process. Each cost center or department is represented in the approval process. Approval units are the basic unit for preparing, annotating, reviewing, and approving plan data. Approval units are combinations of scenario, version, and entity or part of an entity. You can have one scenario version combination per approval unit. Scenarios and versions are the basis of the review cycle. Approval units submit planning data for a scenario and version. Approval units can also include a secondary dimension within any entity, defining the granularity of an approval unit. The approval unit moves from one reviewer to another until the budget process is complete. The review process follows the promotional path you set up when you select the owner and reviewers for an approval unit, unless an event triggers a change in the promotional path. Administrators prepare the approvals process by setting up approval units, typically based on the company's organization, geographical regions, or product lines, designating who reviews and approves the plan data as the data moves through the organization, defining validation rules to ensure plan data meets business requirements, and then initiate the approval process, that is, beginning the planning cycle by officially starting each approval unit. Its state then changes to under review. In the under review state, you can enter data and then promote or submit the approval units when you consider the data ready. After doing so, you cannot change the data until you become the owner again. Next, operational planners prepare the plan for their cost center or department and submit it as an approval unit that a divisional manager or planner in the intermediate management reviews. If they approve the plan, they promote the approval unit upwards through the review path defined for review and final sign-off. During this process, reviewers can perform tasks such as delegate approval units to reassign them, freeze approval units while users work offline in a draft version to finalize numbers and incorporate late-breaking changes, and unfreeze approval units to resume the review process. Let's explore approvals. George prepares revenue data for sales east. Carol prepares expense data, and Kerry prepares remaining data for sales east. You can modify how approval units display. You can sort by criteria such as owner or approval unit position in the approval hierarchy. You can also sort by approval status. You can filter by criteria such as scenario and version, approval status, or approval unit. George has finished preparing the data for revenue accounts, so let's promote that planning unit. Let's log in as George. The change status page records the approval unit's history, including any comments previous reviewers have made. Here are the actions we can take. We could also run any associated validation rules. Because we accept the amount planned, let's promote the approval unit. The approval unit will pass to Frank, who's the next reviewer identified on the promotional path, and then to the owner of the Sales East entity. Let's now log in as Carol, who manages the expense accounts for Sales East. After reviewing expense account data, Carol wants to take some more time to modify the plan. Carol could freeze the approval unit so that it's static while the team works to finalize the plan. When the expense plan for Sales East is ready to be resubmitted, the approval unit can be unfrozen so that the review can be resumed. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.